Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1995, Fill Text on the Subtotal Rows. I'll be podcasting this whole book. Go ahead and subscribe up there in the top right-hand corner to the playlist. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, yesterday, we talked about subtotals, and I have another question that comes up frequently with subtotals. You see, it's easy to add numeric subtotals, but what about a text subtotal? So I already subtotaled by customer, that gets the customer name down here, but if I need the sales rep to come down as well, alright, let me show you this. So first I'm going to collapse down to the number 2 view, and I want the sales reps to be over here, so I'm going to select the range where the sales reps are going to go, so in this case row 49 to row 580, and I'm going to either use alt semicolon. Alt semicolon is the shortcut key for find and select, go to special, visible cells only. All right, that selects those visible cells. And right now I notice I'm in row 49, I'm in column A. I need a formula here that's going to point to A48, the row just above me. So equal A48. Most important part here, control enter will enter that formula all the way down. And we get, what we get is the last sales rep for each of these customers. I've seen this in a couple of different places. Sometimes we have an account number and customer name. You have to subtotal by account number because the customer name changes a little bit from order to order. So you can subtotal by account number and then pull the customer name down. Lots of different uses for this great trick that makes use of the go to special dialog box. Here's one that's not in the book but that comes up a lot. What if we need to sum most columns but count another column, all right? And the way that Excel has us do this is just horrible. Data, subtotal. At each change in customer, we're going to use the count function, and we're going to add that to the sales rep field just to get a count over there on the left-hand side. And then uncheck replace current subtotals. But this is horrible because now we get a count on row 49 and a total on row 50. No. So just remove all. All right, here's the way to do this. We want the count over in column A. So I'm going to do data subtotals at each change in customer. Use the sum function, and we're going to do it to sales rep, revenue, cost of or profit and cost. Click OK. All right, and then on each row, we get this total. Right, that's not what we want at all. But when we look at this formula, it's equal subtotal 9, comma. And if we would edit this, there are choices. Number 2 is count, number 2 and 3 is count text. So what we need there is a subtotal 3 instead of subtotal 9. Select the whole column, control H for find and replace, find every occurrence of open parenthesis 9, comma, and change to 3, comma, replace all. And that now becomes a count out there in column A. Here's yet another bonus tip. If you want that to people to know that that's a record count, select those cells, alt semicolon, control 1 for format cells, custom, and we'll say count, and then the number like that, so you can see how many there are, record count, or whatever you need out there. All right, so lots of different tips in the book. You can order this whole book right now, 40 greatest tips, 25 bucks, great deal. Episode recap, if you need additional text on a subtotal row, collapse down to the number 2 view, select the range from the first text down to the last text, home, find and select, go to special visible cells, or just simply alt semicolon, build a formula pointing to one row above, and then most importantly, control enter says enter this similar formula in all of the cells in the selection. Bonus trick for using sum on most totals and a count on one. Don't use that horrible Excel method where you get the total on one row and the count on another. Put the sum in all columns and then control H to replace, replacing 9, comma with 3, comma. Yep, and then finally a custom number format to show the word count, any word, before a number in a cell. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.